Good morning, children. I hope everyone are fine. Okay. So, shall we begin the class now? Okay, fine. So, I completed that mental maths, right, in the last class only. So, mental maths up to that first chapter is completed in the last class only. Okay. Today, we'll start with the fractions and decimals. Okay. So, that is a second chapter. So, here second chapter, that is fractions and decimals. Okay, I hope everyone know the fractions. What do you mean by fraction? What do you mean by decimals? Okay, all those things you studied in the 6th standard only. Okay, so now you are, that is the again recalling everything here. So I'll tell some previous connect, that is they given here, page number 90. Previous connect, that is a fraction is a part of a or a several equal parts of a whole. Okay. So, what is the fraction here? Fraction is nothing but it's a part or a several equal parts of a that whole. Whole means full part. Okay. So, it is a part or a several parts of the that whole part. Whole part means full thing. Okay. Next, a proper fraction has a numerator which is smaller than the denominator. Okay. So, if the denominator value is greater than the numerator, then it is called as the proper fraction. Okay. If the denominator is smaller than the numerator, then it is called as the improper fraction. See here. Proper fraction means here some proper fraction. See. 2/3. Of course, here 3 is a greater than, denominator is greater than the numerator. That's why it is called as the proper fraction. Okay. Next one more is there. Improper fraction. Improper fraction. Okay. So, in improper fraction, the denominator is smaller than the numerator value. That is 5/2. See ya. 2 is a smaller than 5, denominator is a smaller than the 5, then it is called as the improper fraction. So, this is called as the improper fraction. Okay. So, next one is that they given here, mixed fraction. Mixed fraction is a combination of a whole number as well as the proper fraction. Okay. So, all fraction can be shown on the number line. So, equivalent fractions are nothing but which have the same value. Okay. So, next to get the equivalent fraction, we have the numerator. Okay. To get the equivalent fraction, we have to multiply both the numerator and denominator with the same value. Okay, if you want equivalent fraction, so you have to multiply both the numerator and denominator with the same value. Then only you will get the equivalent fractions. Otherwise, you will not get the equivalent fractions. Getting everyone? Okay, fine. Next is a unit fraction. Are the those fractions which have a numerator as 1. If the in the numerator, the value is 1, that is called as the unit fraction. Okay, if the numerator value is 1, then it is called as the unit fraction. Okay. After that, yes. Start with the do you remember problems, that is page number 20. Everyone has to open the page number 20 here. In that, they given first one. Write the 5 equivalent fractions of a 5/8. Okay. I'll solve 1 by 1. Open page number 20, everyone. Do you remember problems? Okay. Do you remember? In that first question, write a 5 equivalent fraction of a 5/8. Okay. So, equivalent fraction of equivalent fraction of 5/8. Okay. That is how to get the equivalent fraction of 5/8. That is we have to multiply both the numerator and denominator with the same value.
So multiply here 5 by 8 into next multiply 2 by, otherwise write the equivalent fraction like this. 5 by 8 is there.
Write the table.
5 times are 10, 8 times are 16. Next, 5 times are 15, 8 times are 24. Next,
5 fourths are 20,
8 fourths are 28. 5, 5 are 20, 8 5 are 30. Okay? So, like this, we have to write another one. Right? That is, 5, 6 are 30 and 8, 6 are 48.
Okay? So, these are the equivalent fractions of a 5 by 8. We are multiplying both the numerator and denominator with the same value. First I multiplied with the 2 by 2. Next multiplied with the 3 by 3. Next 4 by 4. 5 by 5. 6 by 6. We multiplied it. Okay. So these are called as the equivalent fraction of a 5 by 8. Okay. Next second one. Write a fraction equivalent to 32 by 6 with the numerator 4. Okay, write a fraction equivalent to 32 by 56 with the numerator 4. Write a fraction
equivalent to 32 by 6
with the numerator 4.
Okay, we want numerator as a 4. What is the denominator here? See here. Divide this 32 by 4. Sorry, 32 by which value? 4 means here 8. 8 2's are 16, 8 is 74, 8 4's are 32, right? So we are divided by 8 here. 8, 32 divided by 8 is what? That is 4. Okay, so we return a 4 here. In the numerator 4 is there. Then what we have to divide here? 8 only, because numerator is divided by 8 and denominator must be divided by 8. Then only it will be an equivalent fraction. Otherwise, it will not be an equivalent fraction. So, divide this 56 by 8. That is 8 7s are 56. What is the answer here? 7. Okay. So, 4 by 7 is an equivalent fraction to this with the numerator 4 value. So, this is the answer. 4 by 7 is the answer. Getting? Next, go for the third question. Solve the following questions. Solve the following questions here. Third name, first one. Solve the following. 3 by 5 minus 1 by 4. Okay. 3 by 5 minus 1 by 4. What is the LCM here? 20. Here? 4 is 5. Okay. 4 3 is 12. Minus 5 1 is 5. 12 minus 5 is 7. 7 by 20 is the answer. 7 by 20 is the answer. Okay. Next, go for the next question. That is second one. 4 minus 2 by 3. That is equal to, here nothing is there means 1 is there. Okay. What is the LCM here? 3. Here 3 is 4 3 is 12 minus 2. That is 10 by 3 is the answer. Okay. Next, third one.
Want the given third one?
9 by 15. 9 by 15. 3 by 7. Okay. Take the LCM of 7. 15 and 7.
What is the LCM? 15 and 7.
Multiply that only. Okay. Because both are not in the same table. 7, 5 is 35. We carry 7 into 7, 105. Okay. So next here, 7 is here. 15 is 7, 9 is 63. 15 3 is 45. Subtract. 63 minus 45 is 30 minus 5, 8. 6 minus 5 is 1. That is equal to 18 by 105. Okay. 18 by 105 is the answer. Next, fourth one. Fourth one, that is a pi integer 1 by 3 minus 3 integer 1 by 4. 3 5 is a 15. 15 plus 1 is 16 by 3. Next, 4 3 is a 12. 12 plus 1 is 13 by 4. What is the LCM 3 and 4? 12. Here 4za, here 3za. 16 4za, 64 plus minus 13 3za, 39. Next, 64 minus 39. Okay, 14 minus 9 is 14 minus 9 is 5. 6 minus 4 is 2. That is 25 by 12. This is the correct answer. 25 by 12 is the correct answer. 25 by 12 is the correct answer. Okay. Let's do the next problem. Fifth one, that is 6 integer 4 by 7, 1 integer 1 by 5, multiply, 7 6 are 42, 42 plus 4 is 46, divided by 7, 5 1 are 5, 5 plus 1 is 6 by 5, that is again here, 10, 35, okay, so here 5 are, here 7 are. 46 5s are 5 is 6, 30, 3 carry, 5 for the 20, 20 plus 23, minus 7 6 are 42. So this is equal to what here? 230 minus 42. Okay? So 10 minus 2 is 8. 13 minus 5 is 8. 2 minus 1 is 1. That is 188 divided by 35. This is the answer. 188 divided by 35 is the right answer. Getting everyone? Okay, fine. Next one. Fifth one completed. Go for the sixth problem.
Or the given sixth one. Sixth one. That is 3 integer 2 by 5 plus
1 integer 1 by 5 plus 2 integer 1 by 2. Okay.
So first to convert this mixed fraction to the improper fraction. That is 5 is 15. 15 plus 2 is 17 by 5. Okay. Next. 5 plus 5 is 5. 5 plus 1 is 6. 6 by 5. 2 2 is 4. 4 plus 1 is 5 by 2. Next. Take a LCM. What is the LCM here? 10. Okay.
So here 1 ka, that is 17. Here 6 only. So if 2 is right. Wait. 17 2 is 34. 2 6 is 12. 5 5 is 25. Okay. Now add the numbers. That is 34, 12, 25. 4 plus 2 is 6. 6 plus 5 is 11. 3 plus 1, 4. 4 plus 2, 6. 6 plus 1, 7. 71 by 10. 71 by 10 is the right answer. 71 by 7, 10 is the right answer. Okay.
Next, go for the next fourth question.
Fourth one. Okay. We completed the third one. Now we go for the fourth one. What the given fourth one?
Arrange the following in a
ascending order. First one, the given, what they given here?
1 by 9, 1 by 5, 2 by 3, next
3 by 8. Okay. In the denominator, the values are same, then we can write it directly, that is as the ascending order.
But here in the denominator, there will be a different numbers are there. For this, we have to take the LCM. Okay. After that, we can write the ascending order of these numbers, okay? So, what is the LCM 9538?
That is 9538. 3 3s are 3 1s are, here 5 8. 5 1s are 3 1s are, 8 1s are, okay? So, 5 3s are 15, 15 3s are 45, 45 8s are. 8 with 32, 36. Okay, so 360 is the LCM here. 360 is the LCM. Now, right. That is 360 here 940 right? So it is a 40 by 60. Next, first value here 360 5 how much are 5 7 to 35 1 carry 5 to 37 right here 7. Next here also 360 120 okay so 120 means here 240 okay next here 85 okay 45 that is 3 5 to 15 1 carry 3 to the 12 plus 30 divided by 3 I just take the LCM of those values and same in addition we'll do no that I told you have to do but don't put the addition symbol only put the comma okay so now observe in the numerator value ascending order that is ascending order here 40 by 360 next 72 by 360 next 135 by 360 next 240 by 360 okay 40 by 360 72 by 360 135 360 240 by 360 this is the ascending order of a given numbers so like that we have to write the ascending order of a numbers okay so next one same problem second one you only do first one I solved in the fourth main second one do it yourself take the LCM and make like this only okay after that observe the numerator and write the ascending order second one do it yourself fourth main okay so now I'll go for the fifth main okay fifth main that is descending order of a numbers okay same process as the fourth main but write the descending order only that is the difference one I'll do as an example after that second one you only do okay so here now take the LCM that is sorry in fourth main I did a mistake right in fourth main that is fifth main question only I written taken okay same process don't change it okay I just written a wrong question that is the fifth main question I solved already this first question that is in ascending order descending order means write a reverse process only that is the thing okay so fourth main fifth main you will do it yourself only okay same process but in fifth main they given a descending order fourth main they given a ascending order in fourth main I didn't solve anyone because I solved this only I just confused that question so this only I solved just now okay don't get confused here so write this question only in the fifth main write a descending order don't write the ascending order okay in fourth main do the same process and write the ascending order only that is there getting everyone okay fine next we'll go for the sixth main that is a write as a decimal number Write as a decimal number. That is first main is 3 plus 3 by 10 plus 3 by 1000. Okay. So here that is 3 by 10 can be written as 0.3 okay next this one 0.003 now add the values 3 0.003 so what is the answer 3.03. So write the decimal number means how to do like this. This is called as the if the that number is containing a point, then it is called as a decimal number. So this is the decimal number. Like this you have to do. Okay. Next one. That second one In that second one, they given 5 by 100, 5 by 100 plus 6 by 1000. Okay, that is 0.05 plus 0.006. Now add the values. 0.05, 0.006. Here 6, 5, 0.5. That is 0.05. That is the answer. 0.056 is the answer. Okay.
Next, go for the next question. That is the third one.
Third one, that is 6 plus 6 by 10 plus 6 by 100 plus 6 by 1000. That is 6 plus 0.6 plus 0.06 plus 0.006. Okay. Now add the values. That is 6.00. Here 0.6. Next 0.06. Next 0.006. That is 666. Here 6. What is the answer? 6.666. Okay. 6.666 is the answer. Okay. Now go for the next question.
That is a
compare. 7th name. We'll do the 7th name now. 7th name. Convert.
Seventh main. Sorry.
Compare. Comparison. Okay, that is compare. In that first one, 2.71 and 2.718.
Okay, 2.71 and 2.718.
So we have to compare the numbers. Here nothing is there means 0 is there.
7.10
and 2.718. Okay, so here 0 is there, here 8 is there. Which number is greater? This number is a greater. That is 2.71 is greater than the 2.718.
Comparison means we have to put the greater than symbol or a smaller than symbol. That is nothing but a comparison. Okay. Next, go for the second one.
That is 32.018 and 32.0. Okay, 32.018 and 32.02. These are the two values here. So here, check, observe properly. 32.018 and 32.02 here. So now compare the values 32.018 and 32.022. Okay. Here 0, here also 0. Here 1 is there, second decimal point here, 2 is there. So which one is the greater? This one is the greater. So write here 32.018 is greater than 32. Okay.
This is the greater value. That's why I put up this sign, smaller than 0. Okay. Let's go for the 8th question. Convert 2 fraction into a simplest form.
They given a decimal number here. We have to convert into a
fraction. After that, we have to convert that fraction into a simplest form. Okay, that is 8th main.
First question is 0.8. 0.8 can be written as 8 by 10.
Okay, this is a fraction. But they want the simplest form. Simplest form means we have to cancel the values. Okay.
So 2 fourths are 2 fives are. What is the simplest fraction?
4 by 5 is the simplest fraction here. 4 by 5 is the simplest fraction. Okay.
Next second one. What the given second one here? That is 0.75. 0.75 is 75 by 100. Okay. Now cancel the values. 5 ones are 5. 2 and 5 5s are 25. Here 5 2s are 10. Next 5 3s are 5 4s are. What is the simplest form? That is 3 by 4.
3 by 4 is the simplest form. 3 by 4 is the simplest form. Okay.
Next one. third one, here I will third one, that is 0.375 divided by 1000. Okay, divide the 5 1 5 1 5 0.7 35 2 carry 5 5. Next 5 4 here 5 1 5 5 5 8 5 3. What is the simplest form? 3 by 8. 3 by 8 is the simplest form. Next fourth one, 0.06, that is 68 by 100. 2, 2 3 is 2 4 is 2 5 is 10, 0. 2 17 is 2 25. So here 17 by 25 is the answer. 17 by 25 is the answer. That is the answer. Okay. Next one, ninth one. Convert to a decimal number. Okay. Convert to the decimal number. Convert to the decimal number. That is first question is 4 by 5. Means we have to convert to a decimal number. How to convert to decimal number? See here, 4 by 5 means divide 4 by 5. That is, take a point here, 0, 5 is 40. So what is the answer? 0.8. Okay, like this you have to do. Division, it is nothing but the second one is 3 by 20. Divide 3 here by 20. Take a point here, for that 10 we can do. 21 is 20, that is 0, 1. For this point only we can take a 0, that is 25 is 100. So what is the answer? 0.15 is the answer. 0.15 is the answer. Next one, that is a 5 by 8. Third one is a 5 by 8. Do the division. Same process. 8, take a point here, 0. 8, 6 is 48. Okay. So here 2, 0. Again for that, 8 2 is 16. 4, again for that, 0. So 14. What is the answer? 0.625 is the answer. 0.625 is the answer. Next, last one. 11 by 14. 11 by 14. Okay, here 11 divided with the 14. 0.0. 4 is 4 2 is in 80 here. 0, 11 minus 8 is 3, 0. Here again take a zeros. 4, 7 coming to 80, that is 0. Again take a 0, 4, 5, 1, that is 100. 0, 0, 0. What is the answer? 0.275 is the answer. 0.275 is the answer. This is the right answer. Okay. So next, okay, fine. This is the ninth main. We solved the ninth main now. Next one is evaluate the each of the following. That is, subtraction is there. After that, some problems are there. Up to ninth main. Homework is up to this ninth main. Solve in HW first. Solve in HW. After that, write in a CW also. Okay. Next, we'll continue. That is, tenth one. We'll continue in the next class. Okay. Till that, be safe in your home. Okay. Thank you, everyone.